All right, we are starting out with lipsticks, and these are all the bullet lipsticks that I have. So I think I'm just going to start by pulling out my favorites that I know I'm going to keep and that I know are still good. So I think out of all of these, my favorite lipstick at the moment is the Kiko Gossamer Emotion. This is beautiful and it's so good, so I'm gonna keep this one. My recent favorite has been, I've used this so much lately, it's the Catrice Ultimate Color in a Rose Garden 370. So beautiful. Got it from Betsy from Make Up Your Mind. I know just from pulling these out right now, I saw that this has gone bad. Or it's gone like funky, it looks funky. So I'm just gonna get rid of this one and throw it out. It's the MDM Flow in Bossy. So that one goes in the trash. The Ingla 227 is still good and I use it a lot. Or at least at fall time, it's a nice color. This is a True Rep from L'Oreal 297. Still good, I just smelled it and I'm going to keep that one. This is more of a darker version, and I really love this color. So, although I don't use it very often, this smells so good. It smells like vanilla, very similar to the MAC lipstick scents, I would say. So yeah, I'm keeping this one. It's from Bella Pierre, and the color is Cherry Pop. This is from Medusa's makeup and it's called Sugar Daddy, and this is surprisingly beautiful. It's like a neutral nude pink, I would say. So I'm keeping that. This is way too old. It's a really cool color. And it's maybe considered more like a lip balm, but I've used it as a lipstick basically. So it's from Maybelline, the baby lips, and it's going in the trash. So the next one is the Rituals Nude Pink. This is still really nice. Really too light or too nude on its own, but it's really nice as a topper. This is sort of dried out. It's getting older, so I'm getting rid of this one as well. It's the Wet n Wild Mauve Auto here. So that goes in the trash as well. This one is still good. I'm always a little bit concerned about the color because I don't always feel like it fits my skin tone. I feel like it has a lot of yellow tone in it, but a lot of the times I also really love it. So it's the Charlotte Tilbury Bitch Perfect. So I'm still going to keep that one. And this is a lipstick I've been trying to use a lot lately because it's really nice, almost just as a tint on your lips. It's a bit hard to see. The lighting here is so bad right now. Let me go and see if I can fix that. But anyways, I'm going to keep this one for a little while longer. It's from Bare Minerals. It's called the Pop of Passion and Plumbery Pop. Lastly, I'm just going to mention the Inglot lip color in a pan that I'm definitely going to throw away. It's in my panning project and I'll keep it there for now and I'll try to use it up by the end of the year, but that's not going to happen, I know for sure. But I will throw it out once 2020 arrives. I don't know if the lighting helped, but for lip glosses, I only have three at the moment. I'm kind of into lip gloss these days. I'm sort of moving away from liquid lipsticks and stuff, but surprisingly, I don't have a lot. And I think this I just took out of the package. I haven't even opened it. It's not the color for me. It's like a orangey red, and I don't like that. It's from Steve Laurent. The color name is Red Dress, and I'm going to give this away. The Skin Chemist London, it's more like a lip plumper, but it looks really nice and I sort of consider it a lip gloss. I'm keeping it anyways. And I think that's the only lip gloss I'm going to keep for now because this is getting older as well. It's from Makeup Store in Bluebell. And as much as I love to top this on neuter lipsticks, it's just too old. So I'm going to get rid of this one as well. All right, so next up we've got liquid lipsticks. And I did do a whole lot of research before I got all these lipsticks. And I do like most of these colors. Some of them are getting older, but it doesn't look like they're affected by that just yet. So I'm going to keep most of them, I think. But there's a few that has, I think maybe, okay, let's just go through them. This is probably my top three favorite liquid lipstick. The Contour Cosmetics in Juju. Love this one. So I'm keeping that. The Anastasia Crush. I don't love the formula, but the color is nice. And the Stila liquid lipstick in Bossy. Very classic, popular color. I do feel like it goes a little bit gray on me, which is maybe the point. I don't know. It's beautiful, but it's maybe a little bit too on the gray side, but I'm going to keep it for now and see if I can get some more use out of it. The Huda Beauty Liquid Matte. Gosh, yeah, I think this is in Crush as well is the name. I haven't really gotten around to use this too much, so I'm going to have to use it a bit more to see if I actually like it. The Anastasia in Lovely is a beautiful shade, but I never use it. Like, no. This is... No, I never use it. So I might as well just give it away. Or maybe since it's liquid lipstick, I should just throw it out. The Dose of Colors is probably my all-time favorite liquid lipstick. It's in the color Stone. And I love the formula and the color and everything. All my liquid lipsticks are cruelty-free except from Huda Beauty. And I'm not sure about the Contour Cosmetics because that's a brand I've never heard of. I think I just got it maybe as like a try-on or maybe in a glossy box. I don't remember. So this is the ColourPop lip gloss in Alyssa. Beautiful, beautiful shade. And also in my top three favorite lipsticks or liquid lipsticks. This is my oldest liquid lipstick, but it does seem to still be good, and it smells just as it always has smelled. But the name is Rebel Rose, and it's a little bit darker, but I love the shade still. And lastly, this is all dried up, so I'm going to get rid of this one. It's the Meet Makeup, and it's a lip and cheek tint. I'll quickly mention my lip liners. The only one missing here is the one that I have in my project. Don't even remember where it's from. But I got that one in my everyday makeup, and also these, and I'm keeping all of them. I love them all. I don't get to use them very often because I always forget. But I'm not going to get rid of any of them. So we've got the Makeup Store Matte Lip Liner in Russian. The ColourPop in Lumiere. The NYX in Purple Rain. The Lip Definer from H&M doesn't have a... No, Au Naturel is the color. Kiko Everlasting Color. And this... I think this is 405, yes. And Charlotte Tilbury lip cheat in Pillow Talk. The Kiko Smart Fusion Lip Pencil in 503. And the Karl Lagerfeld and Model Co. collab in... What's the color? This is beautiful, by the way. It doesn't say, but I'm keeping all of them. Next, I've got my chubby lipsticks. And again, I know there's only one that I'm going to get rid of, and it is this one. It's very similar to a few of the other lipsticks that I have, but it's still really nice. Also, it's getting kind of old. Let me smell it. It smells a little bit weird. I'm going to throw this out. It is called the PBJ Smoothie Silk Creamy Lip Crayon. So this is going, beautiful shade by the way, but it's too old. The Makeup Mecca Moisturizing Lip Balm in Show Smile. I'm keeping this. I'm buying all the time. I use this one like constantly. I love it so much. From Isadora Twist Up Gloss Stick in Lovely Lavender. And I'm keeping the Douche. I have no idea how to pronounce the brand, but it's the Winterberry shade. It's beautiful. This is super dark, but I use it as a tint from Laka & Co. Cloud Lips. And the shade name is Storm. I'm also keeping the Lord & Berry Maxi Matte Crayon Lipstick in Intimacy. And the e.l.f. Matte Lip Color in Tea Rose. And lastly, I'm keeping the ColourPop Lipsticks in Tootsie. Even though, this is like the only brown shade I have. And I'm not a huge brown fan. But, yeah, I'm keeping it for now. My lip balms are all here to stay. I'm kind of just using up and throwing away. And the ones I don't like, I also throw away. I don't keep them really for decluttering. At least I haven't this time around. But so I'm keeping all of these. I'm quickly going to go through them again. The Delicious Lip Balm. From Lollipops? I don't know. And then the Fresh Sugar Coconut Hydrating Lip Balm. The Vaseline, which is in my panning project or project pan. I've got two from Cherry Culture in Watermelon and Coffee. I've got a Lip Smacker in Fanta and the Mentholatum. It's like a Norwegian thing, I think. Really good for chapped lips. And the Pacifica Color Quench Lip Tint in Coconut Cherry. Just found another lip balm that I forgot about, but this is also going back into my collection. It's from Beauty Made Easy Lip Balm. That's all it says. I also found this e.l.f. Lip Lock Pencil that I've had for a while now, so I'm going to let this one go. So yeah, that's it. This is what I'm keeping out of all of my lip products. I'm going to go through all of these in a separate inventory video, I think. And this is what I got rid of. Not a whole lot, but compared to how big my, or how small my collection is now, I think it's okay. So now I'm going to put these away and then focus on figuring out where to put these, at least for now. I'm probably going to do a whole nother organization video later on, but let's find a spot for them for now. Alright, so I decided to use this lipstick tray all over again. It fits all my lipsticks and it still has room for two, and also my one and only lip gloss. This seems to be the best, maybe the best drawer for my liquid lipsticks. And maybe I can have room for my chubby sticks as well. You know what? The rest of it I'm just going to put in this next drawer for now. It's just going to stay like this. All my lip balms and lip liners, and then all my liquid lipsticks and chubby sticks are there. I'm going to put these back in the drawers for now.